Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am traditional Japanese rakugo comic storyteller and Broadway performer, and now...
Katsura Sunshine Fashion!
Fashion designer Katsura Sunshine coming to you from Tokyo Studios in... From Sunshine Studios in Tokyo. Oh, this is such a happy day for me, and I hope it's a happy day for you. I know this moment you've all been waiting for, and even if you haven't been waiting for it, I have been waiting for it. This is the launch of the Katsura Sunshine Fashion Series. I want to say fashion channel, but it's the same channel as my normal YouTube channel. Fashion series, fashion channel, whatever you want to call it. I'm picking today to launch the series because season one of the Katsura Sunshine Denim Kimonos with 100% Okayama Japan Blue Denim have arrived. It was about an hour before I was going to start making a video for today. I was like, what am I going to talk about? And then suddenly, from the seamstress, Hanae-san, in Kagoshima, the package arrived. I am wearing the first official version, one out of only 30 that will be made of the first season one, Katsura Sunshine Denim Kimonos.
Katsura Sunshine Fashion!
This is not my kimono. This was actually made for Tanaka-san in Singapore, my dear friend and my business partner. I'm sorry, Tanaka-san, that I'm wearing your kimono before you're wearing it, but I didn't have one made for me. We gotta get them off, and I had to get one to Tanaka-san, so we're sending it off in the post to him tomorrow, but here it is. Look, this is a work of art. So we started by choosing the material from these kinds of swatches from Japan Blue, tons of them. I'm just showing you a couple of them. Found the one wanted. The material we chose, if it means anything to anyone, was denim HB7079. Not quite sure what that number means, but then there's actually some words to it. It's 13 ounce, so this is nice. This is a nice, hard, thick denim, which I love because the collar just forms so nicely around the neck. It's something, it's a hardness that will soften as you wear it, and it softens just like a pair of jeans to the wearer's body. I've been wearing my first denim kimono that I ever made, which was a couple years ago. I'm wearing it almost every day, and it's just awesome. And it's awesome how denim just forms to the wearer's body. It becomes part of you. And it's also called, it has a word to it, herringbone denim, which means herringbone denim. So sometimes English is almost the same as Japanese. So guys, I'm so, so happy about this. I'm so, so proud of this denim kimono. I've got the zippers, which I've explained on some of my live shows, but this way you can change, you can put the light sleeve on the darker side and the dark sleeve on the light side, so you can switch this up. I've also got all kinds of different sleeves that we can show you. Also have all kinds of different sleeves that you can replace this if. We have a beautiful lineup of Japanese print sleeves, which I'll show you in a second. Also, not yet made yet are the New York style sleeves. Those are gonna be awesome. Still searching out the material, but they are going to be awesome. This denim kimono set comes with this denim obi, the obi belt. So on the one side, it's the darker, on the one side, it's the lighter. Like, there's some details in this. Oh man, guys, I'm so excited about this. You got the rivets, you got the little tiny rivets, and if you look really closely on the rivet, it says Jugemu. Who would look on a rivet and expect to find a Jugemu? And those of you who don't know Jugemu, look up in one of my older videos. It's a famous Japanese story about a little boy with a very long name. His name was Jugemu Jugemu Goko no Surikire Kai Jari Suigyo no Suiyamatsu Unyamatsu Furai Matsu Kuneru Tokoro ni Sumu Tokoro Yabura Koji Bura Koji Paipo 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 no Shurigan Shurigan no Gurinda Gurinda no Pompoko Pi no Pompoko na no Chokyu Mei no Chosuke. Okay, I'm not going to get into that now. So this obi in Japanese is called the kako obi. It's the thinner obi, usually worn by men, could also be worn by women if they want. It's usually worn by men. And this is actually the obi that we use for rakugo storytelling. So it's a kind of a thinner one. Then we have a more casual obi belt. And this is called the heko obi. This is also awesome. This is four colors. Hanae-san just sewed this so beautifully. You've got the four colors here. You've got golden red here. You've got a grayish silver side here, and you've got awesome just gold and black here on this side, and you've got the blue to match your denim. So just like that's just, and you can basically tie it in a way that you're showing most of whichever color you want, or you can show all four colors at once. There's so many ways to tie the obi belt. In a future video, I'll maybe put up a couple of seminars on how to tie the obi belts. This belt is super simple. is tied in a, basically tied in a bow, like wearing a house coat. It's very, very, very simple. But just look awesome. I recommend wearing a kimono over a shirt like this. I sometimes wear a necktie. If you want the inner juban, then that would have another collar underneath, just like the kimono collar. That also looks awesome. Another thing that Hanaya-san did, it's an incredible job, is just the stitching, the red stitching in the blue denim. Just blows me away. I love it. Because this is herringbone, I want to go back to the herringbone style, but because it's herringbone, I'm going to put it up on the screen here, but the herringbone pattern is this. It's the zigzag kind of pattern of the threads. So actually, when you look at it from this distance, it just looks like it kind of has stripes, but there are no stripes on this kimono. It's just a different angle that the threads are being hit by the light, and so it looks like it has very subtle shreds. It just gives a very, very kind of, in Japanese, you say kōkyūkan, a kind of real... what can I say? Just a kind of, I'm losing my English. A kind of luxurious feel to the threads, to the denim. I just love the look. And it almost shines. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like to officially launch the beginning of Katsura Sunshine Denim and the Katsura Sunshine Fashion Channel. Music star! I hope I can find some music to match those actions. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so as promised, change the sleeve, lickety-split, with a zipper and a zipper, and there we go. This is called wagara, or Japanese kind of auspicious kind of designs, of all kinds of designs that my friends could choose from when they have their kimono made. These are also awesome. This is a wagara that I actually don't know what exactly what this depicts. It's something you see, I think, at New Year's. But I'll figure it out, and I'll write it down on the screen below here, exactly what this depicts. I'll also show you a couple pictures of some of the other ones you could choose. Anyway, what can I say? From the kimono, to the stitching, to the denim from Okayama, which I'll explain in a future program, to the patch here, the original Katsura Sunshine patch with the logo right here on the shoulder, and then here where you can't see it, but I'll show it in an insert, maybe here, or maybe over here, you got the official Katsura Sunshine button. Man, it's kind of blowing me away. I hope you guys like it, because I love it. Anyway, welcome to Katsura Sunshine Fashion. I have been Katsura Sunshine. See you.
Katsura Sunshine Fashion.